Hello, good evening. Welcome to my channel, Fat Dandelions. My name is Mildred Lee, and in front of me is a bag of red pomelo. Asian people love to eat pomelo, oranges, everything that's citrusy, because Asian people love to eat fruit, especially apples. So, lychee, longan, there are other kinds of tropical fruits that I do not mention, but normally the pomelo, the white one, looks like this. They have a net and a piece of easy string to carry along, but this is the first time that I've seen a pomelo wrapped up in a special bag, because normally the red pomelo looks like this, covered with a net, and then inside there's also covered with a piece of plastic. But this is really the first time I've seen the red pomelo in a bag and shoelaces. I don't know why. I think they thought, like, well, let's make it more, wrap it up and let's make it more cheerful and more presenting. So let's untie the shoelace. I think it's so funny. So here it is. I've untied the shoelace. Get the bag out. So they have some kind of a window so you can see. There is, of course, plastic over the pomelo. I'm gonna take it away. I've eaten this last year a lot of times, because I think in November or in December the pomelo, the price drops from 1.99 to 99 euro cents. So I don't know what it was. I think that was of the bag. So, okay. Oh, please be careful if you use a knife. So the pomelo is a very weird shape, but very big, and it's like you can hold it with two hands. And the outside, it looks like grapefruit, but it's really not a grapefruit. I think it's in between. Because I think the grapefruit is also like the pomelo. You have the white version and then the red version. Of course, I don't eat all of it, but I love to cut with the knife the outside out, and then the inside has a very... It's like the orange. It has... The inside is white, but this pomelo is always so thick, so I wish they had a thinner skin. But of course, if it's a thinner skin, then the pomelo wouldn't be this big. I've bought it like 2 or 3 weeks ago. I hope it's inside not dry. I should have eaten right away, because I'm not sure, you know, if it's already ripened. It's always, because you cannot see through the fruit, it's always a gamble, or you need to dabble, like, shall I open or not? Wait, can I almost... so thick. You need to use strength to unravel the inside. I'm not sure if I can show you all of it. Oh, other way around. My children love to eat these. That's why I love to, at midnight, I like to open this and then put it inside a container. And I put it in the kitchen. And each time the children are hungry, not hungry, but you know, a bit peckish, and then they'll see that I've already opened the pomelo, and then they'll take a couple of pieces or parts out of it and they can nibble on it. I've done this a couple of years that I've bought these pomelos every autumn or winter time, but last year, first time, my younger son opened by himself, so he didn't wait for me to do it. He bought it himself at the Asian supermarket, and he always complains that I buy the cheap pomelos and that the cheap ones are a bit dry. So he buys always the expensive ones. And those are always the succulent and juicy. So my kids know what's exclusive or better quality. They are very smart in that way of looking at things, but I think they in that case they look more like their father. Their father grew up very poor. He had really nothing when he was born and young. Later in life, when he was an apprentice of a teacher that showed him how to do how to have skills. Yeah, I cannot say what my ex-husband did for a job, because we don't speak to each other anymore for a long time, since he already found another wife and we were not even divorced yet. So, well, he loves good quality things also. That's what I want and try to say. Well, I try to clean it up best as possible, but after the hurdle of the skin and then the pit, I think it's called a pit. You open it. That's why I don't clean it so nicely, 100%. You open it. Then you have another hurdle. The outer skin. So that's why I don't clean that very much, because you have still have the outer skin. I think here there's another one. So let's see if I can open it. So then I'll take the outer skin out. Oh, it's very juicy. Look, all the juice coming out. So that's how I clean my pomelo for the kids to eat. try to be gentle. Well, I want to do it in one piece. Sometimes I can do it in one piece, but the difficulty is the corners. The corners you can break small pieces off, and that's when you see that it's not possible to do it in one piece. Like here, I'm not gonna take this out. It's when I take this out, I will lose the corners. So here is the first piece that I can put in the container. That's done. I can do the second one. I'm looking for an opening where I can take out the outer skin or the inner skin. I don't know how you call this. And each time you see, I try to take the pits also away, so it will eat easily. So here I'll take the pit out, and here also I can see I can carefully put these back. Can I take this off without ripping? Yes, okay. The rest I won't take out because it's inside the fruit. I'm gonna leave it like this and then put it inside a container. As you can see, I've only have two parts of the pomelo inside the container. Like that. So everything, the table is a bit messy. And you can carry on until all the parts are clean and then inside the container. So I'm not gonna show you all of it. This is, let's say, the end of the video. And, wait. I forgot. Let's open another one. Wait. I want to open another one. Look, that's what I want. That's what I'm trying to say. If I open another one out and it's not that perfect, I'm going to eat that one. The perfect part, I'll leave it to my kids. So that's the reason why I don't want to break all the parts, because that means that I'm gonna have to eat all the parts that I've broken, and I don't want to eat all the parts that I've broken because it's partly sweet, and because I'm diabetic I cannot eat so many fruit. I eat a little bit but not that much, so actually I clean this pomelo more for my children than for myself. So let's say like this. This is the broken one. I'm gonna eat this one. I'm so happy. Normally it's a tangy and sweet, but this one is semi-sweet. Not too sweet and not too tangy. Just precisely good. I like this. This one I did buy at the Chinese supermarket, the red pomelo, for $2.99. Normally I don't buy these expensive one. I always wait till the price drop at 99 euro cent. But this is the first time, and I think it was the first pomelo also a couple of weeks ago that it appeared in the supermarket. I'm gonna keep this This is a beautiful part. They don't even know that it's broken, so I'm going to put it there. And I'm going to eat this little small piece. The reason why? Because these already are still like this. I still need to cut all the skins out. So I don't know which one is broken or be 100% good. So that's why I don't want to eat all of these, because there's another one behind this. This is the white one. This is the white one and this is the red one. So that's why I don't want to break the parts. I want to keep it as whole as it is, the part, so my kids can enjoy. So that's why. So I'm going to end this video. Thank you for watching. And I hope someday, if you have a pomelo in your nearest supermarket, well, in the nearest supermarket, the pomelo is going to be, I think, like $1.99. But later on, near December, then the price will drop to 99 euro cent. But these red ones are still going to be like $2.99. I don't think the price will drop, but I guess also in December, near January, the $2.99 price will drop to $1.99. So that's what I know of last year. So this year I don't know what's gonna be like. So okay, I'm gonna stop talking. Thank you for watching. I hope someday you will try to eat a white pomelo or a red pomelo. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Oh no, tomorrow. Halloween. I'm going to do a little bit of crafting on Halloween. All right, see you tomorrow. Bye.